the far eastern part of Twente, near the village of Denekamp, on the meandering River Dinkel, lies the wonderful estate Singraven. On the estate, there are special buildings, such as the stately house Singraven, the underlying coach house, and outside the park, the centuries-old watermill and the arboretum. In this episode, we take a look at the house with its park and the old watermill. Singraven is mentioned for the first time in 1381 as the farmstead Hof ten Singraven, then owned by the Bishop of Utrecht, who lent it among others to the Oldenzaalse Begijnen. In 1383, it came into the possession of the Hondenburg family, who in 1415 fortified the house into a manor. In the following centuries, Singraven belonged to the Counts of Bentheim and the noble Sloot family. The latter ordered the ruined house between 1651 and 1653 to be demolished and rebuilt, and added 8 years later the beautiful stair tower. In the following years, the estate came into the hands of the Tuars, Roesing Udink and Laan families through inheritance and sale. Via the 800 meter long driveway, built in 1886 by former resident Hendrik Roesing Udink, we reach the beautiful entrance gates of House Singraven. In the past, there were two building houses in front of the house, but these were demolished to get a clear view. We owe the house as it is to the last resident owner, Willem Frederik Jan Laan. Between 1921 and 1923, he had the entire facade clad with the curious natural stones from the quarry at Gildenhaus in Germany, and so it formed the whole with the adjacent neoclassical stair tower from 1661. A lot of care has been taken on the facade with its beautiful lanterns, the windows and the three arches with doors. Various ornaments also fit perfectly in the hall. We also see this on the corners and chimneys. Willem Frederik Jan Laan traveled extensively and was an avid collector and connoisseur of art and antiques from the 17th and 18th centuries. The beautiful collection can still be seen in the house. Behind the coach house, there are wooden barns for storage, and a little further on, at the Dinkel, where annually you can find a stork couple raise their young. The coach house is located between the house and the wooden barns, which is nowadays often used for meetings, receptions or weddings. Hendrik Roesing Udink, the owner who built the 800 meter driveway, was also responsible for the construction of the coach house and the turret on the manor house. The turret was removed by the Laan family at the last renovation because it was not considered to match the appearance of the house. Around 1921, Willem Laan commissioned the famous landscape architect Leonard Springer to construct an English landscape style park near the house. This architect also designed the arboretum and the idea of Laan. We leave the house for a while and walk into the park via the wooden bridge and arrive at the gates of the flower garden and orangery via this small work of art. At the back of the garden, we take a break and enjoy the orangery and the pond with fountains. The park may not be that big, but it is wonderful to relax and enjoy the serene peace and quiet that the surroundings provide. The footpath takes us via bridges to beautiful water features, and art is present in various places. In 1829, the family Sloot sells the estate and becomes the property of Johannes Roesing Udink, who a year later also becomes mayor of Denekamp. One of the first things he undertook was a major renovation on the facade, and he enlarged the house. The deplorable watermill was also taken in hand and expanded with a bakery and a sawmill. When Johannes Roesing Udink dies in 1858, the management is taken over by his son Hendrik Jan Bernard. There is also a burial cellar with cirque in the park. Hendrik Udink has this built in 1864, probably after the death of his young wife. It is this Roesing Udink that went down in history as the Burnt Udink. The story goes that after a good night of drinking, his long beard caught fire after knocking over an oil lamp. Although the staff hurried to help, it's already too late. Poor Roesing was in flames. They threw him into the dinkel to put out the fire. They succeeded, but he did not survive and died a day later on 18 February 1878. He too is buried next to his wife in a cemetery in the park. We leave the park and follow the dinkel towards the old watermill. The first mention of the mill dates from 1448. The mill consisted of an oil and a corn mill to which the wood sawmill was added later. In the past centuries, the mill has regularly been restored or improved by its owners. The last major restoration took place between 1996 and 1998. The watermill of Singraven is a so-called lower barrier mill. It has three wheels that serve the three mill elements. The oil mill was dismantled in 1900, and since then the space has been used as a warehouse for the restaurant. From the back we see the corn and sawmill on the left and the former oil mill on the right. When the Roosing-Udding family is no longer able to maintain the estate, it comes in 1915 through a public sale into the possession of the Laam family. These rent out the mill to Miller Dissel. Since then, the Dissel family has been linked to the Singraven mill and the estate for many generations. They are also the managers of the current restaurant next to the mill. Opposite the restaurant is the estate store, in Dutch the landgoedwinkel, where you can go for information about Singraven estate. After a nice walk or bike ride, Watermolen Singraven is the place to be where you recharge your batteries in the restaurant or on one of the terraces, before continuing to discover the clean and beautiful nature of Twente. The last owner, Willem Frederik Jan Laam, continued to live in Singraven until his death in 1966, but transferred the 600 hectare estate and the associated properties to the Edwina van Heek Foundation in 1956, who has since operated the estate. The transfer stipulates that the neoclassical facade, the period rooms in the house, and the arboretum must be preserved. With a final look at Singraven House, we will end this episode of Twente Our Heritage.